Let's now study a full wave rectifier. As we already discussed that a rectifier is a device which converts alternating current or voltage into a unidirectional pulsating voltage. A full wave rectifier can also be written as a center tap rectifier. We can also write that this is also called center tap rectifier, because when we'll study about its circuit, we'll see that in the secondary coil of a transformer, we need to use a center tap. That's why a full wave rectifier is also called center tap rectifier. About this, we can also write that it allows positive half cycles of AC, as well as it reverses the direction of current during negative half cycles also. And we can write it uses, we'll discuss in detail with the circuit diagram also, it uses two diodes over the secondary coil circuit of the transformer in two parts. Let's discuss the same with the help of the circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram for a full wave rectifier. Here you can see that in the transformer, its secondary coil is divided in two parts and there is a center tap where we connect a wire which is connected to the load resistance through two diodes connected on the other two ends of the secondary coil. Because of the center tapping, this is also called a center tap rectifier. Here you can see in this situation, when for the input supply, the positive half cycle exists, you can see the terminals of the secondary coil will be plus and minus. In this situation, for the upper part of coil, this will be plus and minus, and for lower part, this would be plus and minus, which are high potential and relatively low potential terminals. So in this situation, for diode D1, we can see that its P side is connected to the high potential side, so it will be forward biased and a current passes through it. But in this situation, when positive half cycle exists, P side of diode D2 is connected to the low potential or negative side. So in the positive half cycle, it will be reverse biased and no current passes through it. And in this situation, this current will pass through load resistance from right to left. So when we talk about the output terminals, these terminals X and Y, when we talk, you can see that Y will be at high potential and X will be at low potential. Now, this is working for a positive half cycle. In the similar manner, when the next half cycle comes, the polarity across the secondary coil reverses. This will become plus, this will be minus. Correspondingly, here it is plus, here it is minus. And in the negative half cycle, you can see that this diode D2 will be forward bias and a current flows through it and passes through the load resistance, and diode D1 will become reverse bias because this will be at low potential. This end of secondary coil is at low potential. So no current passes through it in negative half cycle. So we can write this diode D2 is acting in negative half cycle, but it is also supplying the current through load resistance in the same direction, so that terminal Y is at high potential, X is at low potential. Or we can say whether the input supply is having its positive half cycle or negative half cycle, in both of these situations, current flow through the load resistance in same direction. So the output voltage graph will look like this. Again, it is a pulsating voltage. But in this situation, you can see all negative cycle will also be having the direction of current reversed in the output circuit or load resistance, so that current flows through load resistance in same direction whether it is positive or negative half cycle. Here we can say for positive half cycle, here diode D1 is working. For negative half cycle, diode D2 is working. Again, D1, D2, that we can mention. This is the way how a full wave rectification output is obtained by using two diodes with the center tap in the secondary coil of the transformer.